Hey everyone, and welcome back to another lesson of Trash Academy. My name is Eliseo, and in today's lesson, we're going to be talking about single-use plastics, one of the many sectors where we find plastic. Okay, so what are single-use plastics? So these are the plastics that are only used once, as the name suggests, which may not seem like a huge deal, but we have to remember that all these plastics, including single-use plastics, are made from petroleum, a non-renewable resource that harms communities of people and environments during every stage of the product's life, from extraction to processing, during waste management, and even during recycling. So why do single-use plastics even exist? Well, from the start, all plastics were actually designed as a throwaway product, and single-use plastics are no exception. We find candy, food, water, potato chips, all wrapped and encased in plastic as they provide a sanitary and protective environment that helps during transportation and even during storage. Now, other single-use plastics include plates, bags, bowls, cups, and even cutlery that are only used once for only a fraction of a minute or a few minutes before they're tossed in the bin. So what are some problems with single-use plastics? So the majority of single-use plastics are actually made out of low-value plastic, such as plastic film or a series of plastic films that can be found in a Snickers bars or even a potato chip bag. Now, all these layers make it almost impossible to recycle or even manage this waste, which most of the time doesn't get managed, doesn't get recycled, and only gets burnt or even landfilled. Now, there are other types of single-use plastics that you might even recognize, including polystyrene, which is a foam-like kind of plastic that you could find in a coffee cup, takeout containers, party plates, and even soup containers. Now, there do exist some recyclable single-use plastics, including the plastic water bottle that is made from PET, polyethylene terephthalate, and even milk jugs. Now, one thing I want everyone to know is that only 9% of all these plastics actually get recycled, which is really low for the amount of plastic that actually exists here on Earth. Now, one thing you do from home is to actually recycle the recyclable types of plastics to increase the amount of plastic that actually is recycled and decrease the amount of plastic that is found in our environment. And the rest of the plastics that are not recyclable, which is 5 out of the 7 plastics that exist, are actually landfilled, shipped overseas, and dumped in developing countries. And many of those plastics are actually incinerated, where they are burnt to create green energy for surrounding communities and cities. But what they're doing is actually burning all these petrochemical products and causing toxic ash and poisoning the surrounding communities, where they often develop health issues such as asthma, heart conditions, and even certain forms of cancer. Okay, so how do we even know this? Well, in 2018, the production and generation of non-durable goods, meaning single-use plastics, was actually 50.4 million tons. And out of all that waste, 7.1 million tons was actually incinerated. And last but not least, landfills received 29.2 million tons of plastic waste that came from single-use plastics.
Plastic pollution is complex, and there's no one quick fix that will solve this issue. Five Gyres is continuing to explore the different sectors to work towards target solutions. And to be successful, we must all work together. Policymakers, innovators, corporations, activists, scientists, and individuals. Follow along and join the movement at Five Gyres.
Now I want to thank you all for joining today's lesson, and I hope to see you all real soon.